reactions have been coming in to Team Anna being dismantled. Let's listen into some of the voices. We spoke with Rashid Alvi, D. Raja and Devendra Sharma. Listen into what they told us.
It is not proper on our part to make any comment. It is up to Anna to take decision whether he wants to form any political party or he doesn't want. But it appears that Anna himself doesn't have any confidence in his team. That is the reason. He has dissolved this committee.
Were you all expecting this sort of a difference of opinion within Team Anna leading to the team falling apart?
No, we don't have time even to think about it. So where is the question to make any expectation? It is up to him to take decision whether they want to form any political party or not. If he has dissolved, it is all right. It is his decision. But it is very clear that he himself doesn't have confidence in his team, and he is very right. One of the members of the team is speaking something else. Other member is saying something else. So it is not anybody may come to this conclusion to dissolve such kind of committee. If he has dissolved, it is all right, but it is his decision. We do not want to make any comment on it.
Mr. Alvi, without Anna Hazare himself, do you feel that the political party that the other team members might form will not be a force to reckon with?
No, this question is absolutely a hypothetical question. What will they do? It is their problem. First, let them take decision. Only then we can make any comment.
Being always, I used to say, team quote Anna. Because how far it is team or no team, that is for them to explain. But now it is very clear they are not united on any issue. They have just come at a particular point of time on a particular issue. Because there was an atmosphere in the country against corruption, and that atmosphere continues. Actually, the political parties took up the issue of 2G spectrum scam in the parliament, demanding a constitution of JPC. The parliament could not function for the entire winter session that time. That created an atmosphere. In this atmosphere, only Mr. Anna Hazare and some members who were with him could organize some campaign on the issue of Jan Lokpal. And even the concept of Lokpal is not Anna Hazare's invention. There used to be different versions of Lokpal. Even when Mr. Devagowda was Prime Minister, we did discuss in the United Front Steering Committee how that bill could be, should be, whether Prime Minister to be included or not. All these things, the Jan Lokpal that way is not something, invention of discovery of somebody. They should understand. Mm-hmm. Moreover, the lawmaking is a complex process. You can organize any number of demonstrations, protests outside parliament just to build pressure on the government. But legislations are made in parliament, by parliament, and legislation making is a complex process. I told the Anna team members when they met our party also, legislation is a making is a complex process. It is for the parliament. You should appreciate the parliament and its functions. One should not denigrate parliament, and one should not denigrate all the political parties. Although the so-called Team Anna is the only right-thinking persons in this country, that is where down the line they have differences. I do not know what ideology they have, whether they have ideology or no ideology. Even if they have no ideology, that itself is a retrograde thing. How come such people cannot have an ideology? If they have an ideology, what is that ideology?
All right. Mr. Raja, one more question over here. They are now willing to take a plunge into politics, the team without Anna Hazare himself. Do you think it will be strong enough without the Gandhian himself being there?
I do not know if they want to take a plunge into politics. Let them do, because the Indian constitution doesn't prevent people in forming political party or going to the people with a flag and a banner as a political party. Let them do. But finally, as I said, what is their ideology? political parties do represent some ideology. Political parties have a comprehensive program for the future of the nation and future of the Indian society. What is their vision for the Indian nation and the Indian society? What class they are going to represent? For whose interest they are going to fight? Let them make all this clear. I do not think they have anything. If they have anything, they hide. They must be very open. They demand transparency, and they must be transparent in their approach, in their activities. They must tell whom they represent and for whose interest they speak or they organize campaigns. They must be truthful to the people and the nation.